praise that goes right there. Come on. When I think of all God has done for me, there's a praise that goes
right there.
Brought me out without a doubt, and there's a praise that goes right there. So many times I thought I'd lose my mind, but God has stepped right in on time. Now today I can truly say there's a praise.
Him, praise him, praise God from whom all blessings flow. Praise him, all creatures here below. Praise him above, ye heavenly hosts. Praise God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Let everything that have breath praise the Lord. This is Ambassador L.F. Craig of the Shelter God Safe House and In the Know for New Life. Yes, this is the Father's Business Ministry. Yes, under the umbrella of God being with us and on our side. And we're just so thankful to God that God does not give up on us. God is always birthing in us the plans that he has for us. Once he said it, he will bring it to pass. And so I'm just so thankful to be here. Once again, this is our time of chunk and chew, and we're just so thankful to God that we have been sharing from the book of James, and we're just giving you little nuggets along the way. Put them in your pocket, and when you're going through something, you can pull it out and you can know that, yes, you are rich in God. Yes, God has given us the word of God, and he has given us the spirit of God that lives inside of us. And we're talking this week about James. Speak, slow to speak. It means take time and think about what you're listening to before you react. Don't be so short-tempered. And it comes with, and he talked about it, and it comes with maturity. It comes with lessons learned for a lot of us. And if you adhere to this, sometimes you don't have to learn that lesson. You don't have to buy that lesson, because if you would listen to the lesson that I tell you, yes, you got to think. Think about what you're going to say. Think about how you're going to act. Think about your body language. Think about everything that goes in to being reactive, okay? And sometimes we talk a lot more with our bodies sometimes than we do with our mouth. And you got to be slow to speak even with your body language talking. And James told us when we first started out that if anyone lack wisdom, let him ask of God. And like I said, he's writing a letter. When you sit down and write letters, your thoughts just flow on the paper. And sometimes you'll write a thought and you may not get completely with it. And then it'll come back while you're writing a letter. And so he's coming right back to this true wisdom. He said, if anyone lack wisdom, let him ask of God. And then he comes in verses 13 through 18, and he begins to tell us about true wisdom, being wise. He's telling us how, you know, if you speak and you can't control your tongue, then you're not mature. And sometimes when your actions tell that you're double-minded, you can't be controlled. God hasn't changed his mind about calling you, about anointing you, about using you in ministry. But sometimes you may cause yourself to have to be put in a timeout to learn. And this happens in our lives, but then here's giving us some instructions. Here's giving us how to be able to recognize what it is that we need to really be looking for in our own lives. We're looking at the mirror. I'm looking at, and I'm just sharing with you what I'm looking at in my own life, in my own walk with God, because I don't want to miss what he has for me. And I know the latter will be greater than the past. Okay. And so you learn from it, but you can't be stuck in it. You got to keep moving forward. Amen. Live well, live wisely. So he says, do you want to be counted wise, to build a reputation for wisdom? Here's what you do. Live well, live wisely, live humbly. It's the way you live, not the way you talk, that counts. Because remember, he's the key to the letter of James is letting them know that you have to do something with this that you have received. It's not just to be sitting and waiting and not doing nothing. God has called us to a place of responsibility in the earth. And so it's just say, do you want a reputation of being wise, wisdom? Wisdom, knowledge and understanding, having knowledge, understanding what you know, and knowing how to properly apply it is wisdom. It's one thing to have knowledge. It's one thing to have understanding, but it takes wisdom how to implement what it is that you really know in order to get the results that you understand that it would bring about. If we understand that a mustard seed of faith planted in good soil will produce a great tree, then knowing it, understanding it, and failing to put it in the ground. Mean-spirited ambition isn't wisdom. And when we, and I know I done seen some people have mean-spirited ambition. You know, they're gonna get what they wanna get at all costs. And it seemed like that that's been assertive, but it's the way you go after a thing. You have to be really careful. We're talking about being slow to speak, because it's a, and so sometimes you speak in your way that you carry yourself of climbing up the ladder. Boasting that you are wise isn't wisdom. Now look at me, I know it all. You know, I know this. Not, you know, no. You have to be humble in what it is, because everything that you have, God has blessed you to have it. He has. Twisting the truth to make yourself sound wise isn't wisdom. Okay. And you know, we got these face masks now that we have to put on. We have to cover our nose and cover our mouth, you know, so, but your ears stick out. They want you to be able to hear, and your eyes, so you can see and you can hear, but don't speak as much. And we know sometimes people twist the truth. And so, but if you ask God, God will give you wisdom beyond anything that you can get from anyone else. Come and sit at the feet of Jesus. Come and sit in the room with the Holy Spirit and allow the Holy Spirit to lead you to where it is that you need to be listening to. Okay. And so it's just saying here that, you know, the royal law of God is love. It's the furthest thing from wisdom. It's animal cunning, devilish plotting. And I tell you what, I look at the animal kingdom and it's about survival of the fittest. There's always prey and predator. Always prey and predator. And God is not wanting us to be prey and predator. Whenever you're trying to look better than others to get the better of others or get the better of others, things fall apart and everyone ends up at the other's throat. And this is talking about us sometimes. And even in my research, I was looking and said, you know, the church have entered turmoil and bickering going on because of titles and position. The wisdom of man. He said, that's not it. Having mean-spirited ambition, boasting about being wise, putting down other people to make yourself look better is not true wisdom. It's not from God. That's not the wisdom that comes from above. But real wisdom, God's wisdom, begins with a holy life and is characterized by getting along with others. The wisdom that is from above is first pure. It's not tainted. It don't have no hidden agendas. It don't have no hidden motives. It's not, well, I'm just doing this so I can, you know, so you can help me. I'm helping you so you can help me. You know, I'm scratching your back because I need you to scratch my. It's pure. It's from a sincere place. True godly wisdom. It is gentle and reasonable, overflowing with mercy and blessings, not hot one day and cold the next. The wisdom of God, those that are using and walking in the wisdom of God, not two-faced. That's what it means. And I just put in here the King James Version, just in case I got some people out there that stuck on. Peaceable. This is one of those passages that I don't care where you read it. It's telling you if true wisdom is peaceable, gentle, and easy to be entreated. That means people can approach you without feeling like you know, you're going to put them down, or you're going to, when you do give them something to do, you're going to bite their head off, and they don't know how you're going to be. They don't know how to approach you, because one day they just have to test the wind before they come in, you know, lick your finger and see if they can feel the wind, so they'll know how you feeling on this given day. But the wisdom of God is full of mercy. Full of mercy. I got mercy for people. I got mercy. I want the same mercy I want God to have for me. I want to have that mercy for other people. That's what true wisdom. Full of good works. Without partiality. And he talked about being partial. Showing favoritism. That shows that you have made some decisions about people based on their outward appearance, based on their clout or their status. You have made some decisions. Yeah, I'm going to get in with them because I know that they can help me get where I want to get because they have a title. So yeah, I'm going to be close to the bishop, but I ain't got time for this other brother over here or this other sister over here. Oh, she's just a church member. I ain't worried about speaking to her, but I won't. Without partiality and without hypocrisy, without being two-faced, without being pretentious. Oh my goodness. Righteousness. You can develop a happy, robust community that lives right with God and enjoy its results only if you do the hard work of getting along with each other, treating each other with dignity and honor. Do unto others as you would have them, you would want them to do to you. Do unto you. You'll be surprised. But this is our chunk and our chew for the day, and I pray that God will bless your life. I thank you for being a part, and I don't know when you're listening to this, if you're listening to it at our time that we share it at 12:15 p.m. on a daily basis, Monday through Friday, right here on the Shelter God Safe House Facebook page and also the Shelter God Safe House YouTube channel. We pray that you would click like and click share it, spread it, and we would thank God because we are sowing seed and watering seed, and we truly believe that God is going to give us the increase. He's going to increase your life and he's going to increase my life. God has promised us that he has given us all things that pertain to life and godliness. And if we seek first his kingdom and his righteousness, if we use his wisdom and we apply this and we show kindness to all people, God has promised that he's going to take care of us. God got you. Trust him for it. I love you with the love of Jesus. Remember, get in the know today. You can change your every tomorrow. Your life is worth living and you are valuable and you have a gift down inside of you. Open up your gift. Share it. Thank you for being with us.
Feels perfect. Other days it just ain't working. The good, the bad, the right, the wrong, and everything in between. Yo, it's crazy, amazing. We can turn our heart through the words we say. Mountains crumble with every syllable. Broken, live or die. So speak life, speak life. To the deadest, darkest night. Speak life, speak life. When the sun won't shine and you don't know why. Watch them come alive as soon as you speak hope. days the tongue gets twisted. Other days my thoughts just fall apart. I do, I don't, I will, I won't. It's like I'm drowning in the deep. Well, it's crazy to imagine words from my lips as the arms of compassion. Mountains crumble with every syllable. Who can live or die? So speak life. You say, raise your thoughts a little higher. Use your words to inspire. Joy will fall like rain when you speak life with the things you say. Lift your head a little higher. Spread the love like fire. Hope will fall like rain when you speak life with the words you say. So speak life, speak life to the deadest dark.
Thank you.